Hey, what's up guys, I'm Steph Emmanuel, and yes, I am behind on my schedule of uploading a video every third day, and yes, this is not my workplace, so bear with me, I'll explain what's going on. I'm not at my home anymore, I live in Mumbai right now, and I'll be here for a couple of more weeks, so I think you'll be seeing this room a couple of more times, hopefully. And one more thing, my hard drive, the laptop I use, its hard drive crashed. I thought that everything I did, I had lost it, but it's just now working normally, and I think we'll be fine now. So these were the reasons that I wasn't able to upload videos on time, but things are looking fine now, so I think we'll be fine. But it's a new place, new city, I have a new routine now, and I am still adjusting to it, but you should know that I'm working very hard for you guys. I love you guys, you know that. So please bear with me. So now let's talk about this video. Today we live in the second decade of the 21st century, and the life today is far more easy and comfortable than it was couple of centuries, or I would say couple of decades before. And this is due to the discovery and the advancements in technology around us. So today in this video, we'll be talking about the top 5 tech that just changed the world. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So at number 5, we have wheels. I know you weren't expecting this, but just for 1 second, imagine your life without wheels. There will be no cars, no trains, no metros, no subways, no skateboards, no motorbikes, no cycles. You have to commute by foot or by air. Consider yourself going to office every day by air. That sounds amazing, but it's ridiculous. And you won't be having trolleys and trucks to carry heavy weights. Trust me, life will be very, very slow without wheels. And the amazing as well as the strange part is that no one knows who discovered them. But it was around 3100 BC when they were first used, and they were made of stones. But look now how far we have come. It's just amazing. Now at number 4, we have internal combustion engines, or IC engines. Some of you might think that instead of IC engines or internal combustion engines, I should mention steam engines. But I would like to say that steam engines mobilized the industry, but it was the internal combustion engines that mobilized the people. So those who don't know, all the motor vehicles that you see on the road are run either by internal combustion engines or electricity. But the latter is in minority right now. And internal combustion engines just change the way how people move from one place to another, or they move the goods from one place to another. The days got longer because the time for traveling got lesser, and it was the last decade of the 18th century in which some series of discoveries led to the development of the internal combustion engines, and various scientists as well as the engineers were responsible for it. I hope you are not interested in the names, but if you are, Wikipedia is always there for you. Now at number 3, we have computers. I know you saw it coming from miles away, but computer used to be a treasure in its early days, but now every house has one. Initially they were slow and massive, but now they are ridiculously fast and mind-blowingly thin. They come in all shapes and sizes. You have desktops, you have all-in-ones, you have laptops, you have 2-in-1 laptops. They even come in tablet form. Thank you, Microsoft. And today, we rely more on computer than we rely on weather to get the work done, because they let us store and retrieve vast amount of data instantly. It's just magic. And suppose if a person arrives from 19th century today, I'm sure he would go nuts. He would have his eyes out of his head. This is how far we have come. And trust me, we have a long way to go. Now at number 2, we have mobile phones. I know it's unfair to skip the technologies like telegraph, radio, and coming directly to the mobile phones, but you must understand that the discovery of mobile phone was a much bigger leap forward than all other we mentioned. It was just more convenient and easier to use. Mobile phones just changed the way how people communicate with each other. Transfer of information became much easy and convenient. World just entered into the fast lane with the discovery of mobile phone. And some of you might be thinking that iPhone changed the world. I mean, yes, it did change something, but not the world. It only changed the way how people use their mobile phones. Or we can say it just changed the ergonomics of the mobile phones. So now coming to the last tech that changed the world, I think you should have guessed it. Because of that technology, you are watching this video. Yes, it's the internet. Initially, it was computer to computer network. But after developing an innovation for a couple of more decades, the internet finally became global. It's not world-changing technology as real, but it certainly is on par with internal combustion engines or the mobile phones. You can access information about anything from anywhere in the world, thanks to the internet. The internet is so powerful and we have just started to take advantage of it. And I called it so powerful because it has the capability of accelerating the speed of inventions as well as the innovations. And that is what is needed to grow in future. But at the same time, the internet is responsible for making people socially isolated. But just like any other invention, it accomplishes good or ill totally on the basis of how you are using it, if you know what I mean. So that's pretty much it for this one, guys. Feel free to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and if you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you hit the subscribe button. It's going to change your world. Once again, guys, thanks for watching. Please bear with me and I'll talk to you in the next one.